Yes, yes, yo. Hey, you don't stop. Stop. Juanita. What's up, y'all? Welcome to Connected. I'm your host, DJ Iz. I got my lovely co-host, Miss Cloie. Say what's up, girl.
Happy Monday movement, y'all.
So today is Monday Takeover. Now, we got one of the busiest, hardworking DJs in LA right now. Give it up for my man, DJ Malski, y'all.
What it be like? What it see like?
See, he came prepared. He's got the lingo. He's got the hand movement.
Yeah.
So shout out to Malski for showing up. I remember talking to you, man, about a year ago about what we were doing with Connected, man. And here we are.
It's
Monday
happening.
Takeover, it's happening.
Monday's being taken over.
Yeah. It's been taken over. Now this cat
is doing everything.
He's doing everything.
He's
now
DJ,
we're talking LA Rams.
For the Sparks.
USC, KJLH, man.
Bible studies and strip clubs.
Listen, you know, I'm tired just with that list. I got so like, it's
thank
hard.
You. Thank you.
Yeah, absolutely. And you know what, man, we're actually happy to have you on today's show. We're in the house of Roland, man. Shout out to Roland. Of course, my man is representing on the DJ 808. You know, and man, what can I say? Man, remember the days of carrying crates, bro?
Oh, man.
You know what I'm saying? You can actually just show up with your laptop.
Yeah,
41 with your laptop.
Yeah.
Now, you know, you don't got to hit the homie up like, hey, bro, I got a gig, man. Can you come with me?
Can you bring a dolly?
Can you bring a dolly?
But do you miss it, though? Do you miss it? No part of it.
No.
You know what, though? Even for me as a DJ, I miss the art of, like, doing this, like, looking at the crowd and saying, okay, you know what I'm saying? It's a whole different thing back then, bro.
I don't miss it.
He's like, my back doesn't miss it.
You see, this is why I'm excited about the Roland 808. I'm excited. Listen, 965,000 songs in the can. There's nothing. I could go anywhere. I love it, man.
You're
accessibility.
Look
love
you.
It. We could do anything.
So for, because I know we get DJs tuning in. So what's like what you just said, right? So having that many songs at like the touch of your finger, being able to access it right there. Just give me one tip as far as aspiring DJs that have a huge library of music and they read a crowd. Like, what is that? How important is that for DJs that have access to that many songs?
All the DJs that I have, you know, under our umbrella, I tell them never show up with a set. Just don't show up with a set. Mm-hmm. Show up, read the crowd, and go based on the crowd. As opposed to showing up with a predetermined, I'm going to play this, and they're going to like it.
Mm-hmm. Right.
Just show up and read the crowd, if that's what you do, and make it a good time for them, because that's our job at the end of the day. So don't have it set. Don't have a set in your mind. Show up and be open. And this gives us that opportunity. See, back in the day, you only could get 41 vinyl in a crate, so you could, you know, you had a select choice. You
it's
had
just to like live in the moment of these 41.
Absolutely. You had to play what you brought, right?
Yeah.
But nowadays, with the accessibility of so much songs, you could feel the crowd. It's better.
Yeah, and you know, and that's so crucial, man. You know, this show, as you know, Jay, is yes, we want to provide jobs and opportunities for aspiring creators and musicians and cats that are rocking film and all that. Mm-hmm. And, you know, we try to offer as much privileged information as we possibly can. And what you just did for a lot of cats who are aspiring to DJ is a lot, man, because they're in the game where they're trying to figure out, do I get turntables? Do I get a controller? Mm-hmm. I got all this music. But, yes, you have all this music. But the key thing is, like you said, being able to read a crowd and know what record to play, which leads me to more tips that my girl Cloie put together on the job tip. Cloie, you're busy.
Yeah,
I need you to focus on the show.
Oh, sorry. Yeah, so, I'm sorry. So, I'm back. I'm
so
back.
Go ahead and introduce this job tip clip that you wonderfully, so elegantly put together for them.
This whole thing? Okay. Stay tuned for this job clip. It's all about what do you do when you get the interview? How to, like, not screw it up. Should we cut to it?
Cut to it.
Make it happen.
Job tip number 4. Interview advice part 2. Last week, we talked about how to approach a job interview. This week, we will look at what you should say and how you should say it during the interview. First, get into character, i.e., the right mindset before you leave your place. Don't wait until you walk into the door of the company you're interviewing for. Second, be honest. If you don't know something, say so, and that you'll look it up as soon as the interview is over. Third, don't talk too much about yourself. The word I can be a dangerous thing, as there is no I in team. Fourth, position yourself as a team player, someone who is quick to share success with others, willing to accept blame when warranted, and focused on what's best to achieve a goal rather than what's in it for yourself. The interview process is a job skill, and just like any job skill, you need to practice it to perfect it. In the meantime, good luck with your next job interview. Go.
Sounds so professional and like so proper. I love it. It's proper. It's fly. It's cool. So I'm just gonna dive into this right away because I feel like what we do here at Connected is very much that what you were talking about. Mm-hmm. And you know, Jay, for us, man, it's always been about presentation, mm-hmm. right? When you show up to a job and you're looking to like really lock it in and nail it, mm-hmm. there's a couple of things you got to have in place, right? You know, you gotta be on time.
Don't be late.
Gotta be on time.
So, like for instance, we drove out here today, right? And yes. I know you're about 45, at least 45 out.
Yes.
So you know, just going off the cuff, okay? I gotta factor in traffic. That might put me at this. So you know, and it's really about mapping your day out prior to attending mm-hmm. your or applying. You know mm-hmm. what I'm saying?
And it's for sure.
So many folks just kind of wake up oblivious, not factoring the possible obstacles that can just pop up.
Absolutely.
You know? Maybe you're a person that needs to eat the breakfast.
Yeah.
You got to make time to eat the breakfast. Maybe you get hangry. Mm-hmm. You know?
Yeah. And mm-hmm. I think, you know, what's key too is there's certain measures on how you're going to execute this interview mm-hmm. with it, whether it's your resume, whether it's a great sizzle reel, mm-hmm. knowing how to talk to that person, mm-hmm. knowing how to speak well. And it's funny too, because I just been spending a lot of time at high schools doing career days. Mm-hmm. And one of the things I always talk about and implement is this right here.
Yeah.
You know, most conversating, important. You know, yep. talking with folks mm-hmm. and really allowing people to feel the confidence you have within yourself so 100%. That they get the vibe that you're actually adequate for this job.
Eye contact. Mm-hmm. We don't talk about eye contact, but I think it's a huge thing just absolutely. In the world in general. If you don't want to look somebody, what are you hiding from? That sort of a thing, I think, is also a very, very mm-hmm. big thing.
Yeah, yeah.
And also having mm-hmm. to do your research on the person or the company that you're interviewing for with before getting there.
Yes, that's right. So that you know.
Yeah.
You know, you could right. be walking in the office and walk past one of the big bosses,
right.
and if you're not up on the information mm-hmm. of the company, they just walk past, and that could have been an opportunity sure. to yeah. spark a conversation.
To make a
move. Yeah. So you kind of got to do your research prior to.
Yeah, mm-hmm. absolutely, absolutely. So, yeah. you know, first of all, again, dude, we're so happy to have you on here, man.
Man, and, thank you. Appreciate
you know,
it.
Just somebody I consider a brother. That we actually spent a lot of time growing up together.
Absolutely.
Each other pursue their crafts, man. And mm-hmm. happy to have you, man. We're in the house of Roland. You know, yeah. so this is yeah. a part of the show where you get to kind of like kick your feet up, mm-hmm. relax.
Literally, yeah. if you would like to.
The table's a little out of my leg.
So I can put my shoes on the couch. On the couch. Thank you, Roland.
Sneaker game strong, boys. Sneaker game is strong.
So, you know, man, you know. On this show, we've been introducing jobs since okay. day one. I think we're roughly over close to 400, maybe over 400 jobs.
Wow. I can tell you in a second.
Hit me with that number.
Wow.
Between 371 and 380. These are the jobs, 371.
Wow. Yeah. So, man, you know, this thing is really taking a whole nother life of folks just really looking to be a part of this connected culture mm-hmm. that we've created, man. And mm-hmm. it's really about, you know, allowing creators of all sorts in the arts to really just connect with other creators, mm-hmm. you know, because if you mm-hmm. got a dude who's doing film, that film guy needs music,
mm-hmm.
he talks to music guy, hey, here's mm-hmm. some tracks, you know, and that's how the connectivity happens, man. So I know you're well up to speed on what we do here at Connected,
yep.
man, and
mm-hmm.
like I said,
I did my research.
You did your research, man. I think he's even tuned in a couple of times.
Absolutely,
and
absolutely,
kind of, you know, just to check out what
because I want to actually, you know, be a part. I want to offer a few. I'm engaged to about 11 different colleges, and so I want to offer some. It's kind of out of season now. We're just mm-hmm. ending, you know, athletic season as far as colleges, but I want to start to offer a couple of jobs, you know, via you guys' medium too.
Oh, totally.
You
know,
to I some love. Aspiring DJs, yeah. some on-court hosts, some MCs.
Yeah.
You know,
so there you mm-hmm. have it, viewers. I would suggest you get your questions ready for mm-hmm. Malski, because when we get to the Q&A, you don't want to miss a beat. Now, we've had a lot of aspiring DJs, bro,
okay.
who have like
logged on and have had really, really key questions, you know, versus controllers, actual turntables, what do I do? How do I get a gig? You know, the whole nine. So I want to make sure these folks are able to extract as much info from you when we get to our Q&A. So
gotcha.
It's like DJ Double Trouble.
Yes.
That's the new group, yo.
Yo.
DJ Double Trouble.
Yo. I tell you what. You're welcome. I wear black fur. And you wear white fur. And we did.
I mean, what's going on? So before we kick this thing off, Cloie, is there anything we need to get into before we get into these jobs?
Yes. Yes, we do. We need lots of things. We need a bright attitude, a shining disposition.
Yes.
We also need your pens, your pencils, whatever you're going to take notes with, grab it. Grab it. If it's your texting, your device, your tablature, whatever, get it. Because this is the time. Nobody's waiting for you.
And
not
also,
even
too, Mosky, just so you know, I mean, we're really key on details for these jobs. You know, we're not sending folks out there blindfolded.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Like, you got to prepare. You got to do your homework. You know, to really apply and execute these jobs, man. So we're going to kick off the first grind up of the day.
Okay.
Which is in the field of...
Drum roll, please.
Bam! Right there. Music production assistant engineer. This is in Van Nuys, California, our backyard. Top studio looking for an experienced assistant engineer for North Hollywood area studio. Responsibilities include setting up audio equipment and pro tools for sessions. Point five. Export and import stems and build out sessions for mixing. Now, here's what's dope. This job didn't even say at least to 2 years experience. But we all know to do a couple of those things.
You need to have some experience.
You need to have
some experience. Like what, though? Like what? Let's talk about it.
So, for instance, you need to know what stems are. Now, stems are certain parts of the session that a lot of folks tend to ask for these days, especially if you're submitting music to, like, film, a producer or a remix. They want stems, and stems are a group of parts of audio elements to the song, and that's how they want them. And, you know, I'm assuming if you're an engineer in today's recording world, you kind of know this already, but you'd be surprised how many folks kind of get in there and kind of have to, like, kind of dodge some things, you know what I'm saying?
Have to Google a few things. Sure.
Well, the thing is, if you don't know it, there are certain things in engineering that if you don't know it, you don't know it.
Right.
And it shows, you know? Stems, knowing that each of the stems are individual parts of a song. So, you know, if there are eight background parts, a stem of each of those parts. Readily available and ready to be mixed.
Yeah.
If you don't understand that, if you've been working, no diss to anybody, but if you've just been working on your, you know, some program, you wouldn't know it.
And that's another great thing, because Mosky is actually a producer as well. So he knows both sides of the spectrum. Mm-hmm. DJing, playing records, that's great. But he also knows how to record music and finish a product. And I think, you know, the key things is some things are getting lost in translation right now with audio and artistry and what's cool and what's popular. Like, we came up in the days of 2-inch, right? Splicing two-inch reels to the studio. So now, you know, in this particular grind up, you know, it mentions Pro Tools, which is a computer-based software. Mm-hmm. And, you know, some of the things, you know, you have your benefits, right? You have... You know, the economics are much more affordable, you know, because you can pretty much get what you need to get done on a laptop, a couple, you know, audio plugins or whatever.
So self-sufficient.
Self-sufficient.
Mm-hmm. Right.
Mm-hmm. And in the interim of that, we've kind of lost the art form of engineering and mic placement, you know, EQs, outboard gear.
Yes.
You know, and I think it's so important that folks understand both sides of the spectrum. So then you can create a hybrid. Which becomes then your template that you kind of, you paint from as an engineer.
Absolutely. I mean, I tell people that, relating it to DJing, I tell people that, they're like, should we start on vinyl? Should we start on control? And I don't want to jump ahead, but, you know, I tell them, you should start on what originated. Start on vinyl and then learn the controller so that you can have the knowledge of doing both. In engineering, it'd be the same way, you know. If somebody gives you the opportunity to go mix on an SSL, go mix on an SSL. Yeah. Get out of Logic.
Get out of your laptop.
And Reason and go mix
touch on some knobs.
And touch and feel and understand where this all came from.
Yeah.
Because that helps you all around.
It's like back to basics.
Back to basics.
Or the starting at the basics before you jump ahead like 17 million steps.
Yeah, you're trying to dunk and you can't even dribble.
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
and you know, another thing too, Maul, is I think what's great for this kind of opportunity is that we have a lot of students who come out of RFC who are well-equipped, well-certified, because they're not showing up to a classroom every day. You know, when they show up, they're showing up to a studio. They're working with people in real time. They're working with artists. So they know when to infuse their opinion. They know when not to. They know when to be a fly on the wall. And that's another thing we talk in this day and age is man, just know how to be quiet when you're learning.
Be a fly on the wall. Just don't be noticed.
Right, yeah.
Just don't be noticed. Yeah. I could tell you countless times. I could tell you a time of driving all the way to Minneapolis, staying there for 2 months with two super producers, watching, listening, not being noticed, and just waiting, and then coming back and having an opportunity. Because I didn't say anything. I didn't push. I didn't try. I just watched. I listened. I was just a sponge taking in information, you know?
Yeah.
Mission absorbed.
And then you take in, and then when you get your opportunity, you rock.
You rock, yeah.
You rock when you get your opportunity, and that's the best way to do it. You don't want to walk in cocky and you ain't done nothing yet. You ain't earned the right to give your opinion. Yeah. You ain't earned the right to touch anything yet. So you want to start off learning, start off humble, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
You know, in that sense.
So, well said, bro. Well said. So that, again, that grind up was in Van Nuys, California, our backyard. So
literally,
if you're from Cali and you're an engineer,
make sure you
apply for that particular gig. So before we jump into grind up, so what do we got?
Oh my gosh, guys, before we jump into grind up two, of course, we have our student success, our newsletter.
Yes.
So this every week we are highlighting some of our RFC students and alum and that are out in the world and doing a thing, right? So this week's shout out goes to Chris Locke. Yay, Chris.
Chris Locke, we see you, man.
Yes. Chris, after he graduated, was hired at his mentor's studio, and he worked there for 4 years before opening his own studio, and he's specializing in hip-hop.
Nice.
Dope.
This is what I'm saying. He was actually just named Engineer of the Year in Austin.
Wow. Nice.
Congrats, dig it.
Chris.
Right?
So, great stuff.
I know, right? For more information on Chris, check out the newsletter that'll be coming out a little bit later today.
That's awesome, man. I think, too, you know, I always say it's so great for us at Connected to make sure we highlight the folks who are on the ground, in the field, making stuff happen in real time. And he's a perfect prime example of what you can do out there. You know, when you're connected to your passion and you're doing what you love and you're willing to climb that mountain. I mean, that's key for our viewers. So great job, Chris, man.
It's happening. Life is happening.
Always.
Well,
you know, you got your go-to character. She has a go-to character
that's
voice
the go-to?
That she goes all the time.
Do what? Oh, now I got to switch it up.
Uh-huh.
I will have a new go-to character voice. I've taken the note. I've heard the note now.
Yeah.
I will have a new go-to character voice by the end of this episode.
Well, while you get that, I'm going to go to this next grind up. This is grind up two of our Takeover Monday. Let's check it out. This is in the field of Real Editor, okay? Sports Highlight Real Editor, New York, New York. Bleacher Report sports website seeks editor assist in editing highlight reels from college and professional games. General duties include creating B-roll packages of live clips for playback, fulfill highlight requests for social media and daily video team, edit clips from previous week's games. Must be familiar with Final Cut Pro or Adobe Premiere. General knowledge of college level and professional sports.
Boom.
So here
so
we,
that wouldn't be me. I know that I don't know anything
that
about.
That wouldn't be me.
I know those guys really well.
Yeah. Right? Okay. So here's what's crazy. So like here now we have a grind up that kind of says, hey, need to have some experience in Final Cut Pro, Adobe Premiere. So
the sports.
Yeah, the sports is, and that's great because that's a world you're in all
absolutely.
The time.
Absolutely.
You know. So just looking at that grind up, what are some of the things that kind of just jumped out at you right away?
Well, first of all, you got to know what looks good in a sporting world. You know, what looks good in music videos is different. It doesn't necessarily compute to the sporting world.
Right,
so
no twerking.
No twerking or no, you know, whatever. You would bring up
twerking. No gas pedal.
You would bring up gas pedal, right?
No, I wouldn't. My mother watches this show.
But no, in this, you got to kind of know, it said at the end, the experience of knowing, you know, professional and college sports. It's knowing what people want to see. So if you're doing, say, content, I work for the LA Rams. Shout out to Chris Slope Kapura. He's over all the media for the LA Rams. What he's looking for are things that catch sporting lovers' eyes.
It's not spontaneous.
Yeah, it's quick, it's fast, it's bright, it's colorful. it's not mundane, it's not dull,
right.
You know, and so not only that, but it's cut, the way it's cut is quick, you know,
yeah.
Really fast, high energy. The music even that goes along with it, all of that you would have to have and be right. Ready.
Yes,
to,
it's all know. Impact. And I think too, one of the reasons why we stress, you know, to our viewers who are looking to take advantage of an opportunity like that, mm-hmm. we say, hey man, send in your sizzle reel so we can look at it, because like you said, sports is a very different dynamic impact. Man. Than yes. music.
Yes.
You know, sports is like no time for rest. Just none. Wow factor.
In impact. The moment, spontaneous, yeah. constant. It's not up and down. It's right. constant mm-hmm. maxing. Right. Constant, you know, crescendo.
Yeah. It always feels like a Nike commercial or like a Gatorade with the sweat pouring down. That's yeah. what I think of yep. when I think yeah. of
that's
sports.
The culture. And, yep. you know, it's so key, like, you know, to really be in tune with the culture of what it is you're creating content for. Mm-hmm. You mm-hmm. have to know the language. You got to know what it looks like. You got to do your homework. And it's really easy homework. Like, with any facet of what we're talking about, whether it's musicianship, record, like, you can go on YouTube right
you
away.
Sure
yes, you can.
And identify yeah. really quick mm-hmm. with what it is, what it looks like, what yeah. it's supposed to feel like. So I think just being that that's a road you're in all the time, I mean, that's mm-hmm. something he sees on a day-to-day.
Every single day.
I will mm-hmm. also say that for a grind op like this, uh-huh. I feel like what's going to be one of even it's something even more advantageous is to be a lover of sports. Like that's how they say, like, yeah, you have to have some experience. But more than that, and it has to do with that passion that you're talking about.
Right.
Right. Yeah. Because you could be able to edit it. You could speak that language. But if mm-hmm. you don't have a love for it.
Yeah. It's not going to come across.
Mm-mm. Right.
Yeah. It's not going to.
You got to romance yeah. it.
Absolutely.
You know what I mean?
Absolutely.
You got to take it out to dinner.
Absolutely.
Some rose petals for it.
Is that romance? Is that where we are? Okay.
That's what some
good
say.
To know. Good enough.
That's what some say.
So again, folks, that was out in NYNY. That is mm-hmm. video editors for sports. Okay. Boom. Keep that in mind. Sports.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Before we jump into grind out number 3, I'm going to let you have it.
We've got this thing. How's that for a character?
Okay,
is that better?
Okay.
We've got this thing.
We've got this thing. That's kind of amazing. For those of you that don't know, the Rock Dwellers, which is a fine shout out to the Rock Dwellers, we have an app.
Mm.
Connected. There is an app for that.
Yes, sir.
Mm-hmm. Connected.
Now, it's something mm-hmm. we kind of been bragging about for, you know, the last, a little over a month now, I want to say.
Has it been a month?
It's been a month. And it's great because, you know, one of the things that tends to pop up in our Q&A a lot is, mm-hmm. how do I get to this? How do I meet this? And what the app is great for is it connects you and, mm-hmm. and corresponds you with people that are near you, whether mm-hmm. it's 5 miles, whether it's 60 miles.
Mm,
so you're nice. Able to start a dialogue with creators that you didn't know existed in your area.
Mm-hmm. That's
and, dope. You That's know, dope. You can also, like, let's say you're a DJ. Mm-hmm. You can put your DJ fee up there. You can put your bio, what you've done.
Mm-hmm.
And really, you know, promote yourself in a way that allows people to see you in a business fashion.
Mm-hmm.
You
know, see, so that's dope.
It makes it easier. Like that's I tell folks all the time, how much easier can we make it for you guys?
Not
we're
at
all. We're providing jobs.
Yeah.
It's geo-based.
It's geo-based. You know, and all you got to do is get onto your Facebook and, you know,
connect.
Enjoy this app through Messenger mm-hmm. and connect. So mm-hmm. we always make it a point to remind folks we got an app
mm-hmm.
and should definitely check it out. You know,
dope.
So, yeah.
Dumb. So check it out.
So check it out. Right now.
The end.
So Cloie,
no, we'll
I'm,
wait
I'm,
for you.
I'm going to let you take over this grind up. This next grind up.
Oh, grind up number 3?
Let me do it.
Oh, you want to do
oh,
it?
Oh, yeah, you want to
do it.
Go
yeah.
for it, man.
You should let me do the next
okay.
grind up.
Go on, get it.
Go on
so we're going to roll it for
Do it like it's in a stadium.
Yeah, do it like it. You're ready for TV.
Are you in character right now?
No, I'm not. I got clothes. I'm just joking.
No, you're going to do it. We are always.
I got it. We're in character. We're okay. always
We're going to let you have it.
Grind up number 3.
All
Bam.
Right. Grind up number 3. DJ needed in Lansing, Michigan. Top restaurant nightclub needs experienced DJ to keep the crowd alive. Responsible for music selection and directing the party. Will be responsible for overall entertainment programming. Have to have knowledge of DJ and sound system is a must. At least 1 year experience as a DJ in a party or club setting. Equipment provided.
I guess this is my cue. I guess I'm fired. Like my man just kind of came in and blazed his grind up.
With his DJ boy.
Hey. He got on his slightly Don Cornelius.
Wait, that's where. I think for the rest of the show, that's how we all
Don
have to do it. We
Cornelius.
All have to do it like our version of Don Cornelius.
So, Jay, that was actually a perfect grind up for you to introduce, man.
Perfect.
And just mm-hmm. looking at those details, mm-hmm. what are some of the things that, just first and foremost?
Well, first to be over all the entertainment at a place. What happens is venues come and they want to set a certain mood in their environment, right? Stores are actually getting involved in it. But let's say, whatever, Fridays, the restaurant, they want to set a certain environment when you walk in, right? Mm-hmm. So first of all, you'd have to be familiar with what they want to set, what kind of environment they want to set. Yeah. If it's Hooters, it's one thing. If it's Katsuya, it's something else, right. You know? So you'd have to be familiar on what environment they want to set. And then, based from that, can you set that environment, right? On mm-hmm. a consistent basis in different formats, via live band or via just certain music playlists. Right. Like if, you know, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursdays will be a certain vibe. The weekends will be a different vibe. Right. You know, understanding that mm-hmm. and then being able to set it.
Right.
That's really pretty much the gist of that. I would say if you're in that area and interested and you understand music, it'd be an awesome opportunity. Mm. Awesome opportunity.
And what's your take on like the very last detail, which was equipment provided?
Well, if you don't know how to use certain equipment, mm-hmm. then that means your experience level has to be at a certain place where whatever they provide, you could use.
Gotcha.
So, you know, generally when as a DJ, when someone says equipment's provided, it's 90% of the time it's turntables and a mixer,
mm-hmm.
you know, pretty much, you know, 90% of the time.
Okay.
But you just have to have some experience in that. Right. It also said experience needed too,
right.
because you would have to understand, look, if it's a clean, if it's a family friendly environment.
I talk about that all the time.
You gotta have clean versions.
Clean
versions. You gotta be able to adapt to whatever environment, man.
No two lab crew on Friday.
You can't, get it.
Right.
Oh.
Okay. No, that's so true. That's so true. You know,
I wanna rock.
No. Yeah, no, but that's a great point, because I even run something similar to that, which is the quality of your MP3s even after that.
Yes.
You know what I'm saying? Like, mm-hmm. it's great, yes, you got it, clean versions, but also like audio clean versions as well. You know?
Hey, stop downloading stuff from YouTube, man. Stop go get real music, man.
Yeah.
Stop doing that, man. Getting that bad. We hear it. And it's a big difference.
It is. No, it really
is.
I agree.
It's a huge difference. Listen, I give you a great example, right? I'm doing BET Experience. At that night, it was Tinashe, Ray Shremmer, Neo, and Nicki Minaj, right?
Mm-hmm.
In between, so I'm the host and DJ for the whole night at Staples Center here in LA. In between, there was about a 15-minute gap in between each, right? Well, Nicki Minaj was 49 minutes late. No one knew why. No one understood. In that, I'm playing music, trying to keep the crowd, and everybody's dancing and in it.
Right.
I'm playing all these great songs. Well, there was one song, an artist came up to the booth, and the artist is pretty known, Busta Rhymes, comes up to the booth, and I want to play a certain song that he has. But I don't have the version that's clean.
Mm.
So I'm like, what do I do? So, you know, on the cuff, I just download real quick, try to find a quick version, and it was a terrible version.
No.
I play it, and while people love the song, you could hear the difference.
Right.
So from then on, I just vowed I'm never going to do that again.
Right.
Because
so
you can hear
out.
The difference.
Man, that's such an important
out.
Story, bro.
So
you could hear
out.
The difference.
You can hear the difference.
Like, it didn't beat like the high quality version would beat in the Staples Center.
Right. That's disastrous.
It's disastrous.
It is.
That's disastrous, yes. Here's my other question, though. The people, like the lay people,
mm-hmm.
did they notice a difference? Not that, and this is not about making excuses or whatever, so this is not what I'm saying. I just want to know from my brain.
Well, what happens is there's a subtle, a subconscious decrescendo in your brain, right?
Mm-hmm.
So at any party, when there's a hype song coming on, you innately want to move and stand up. If there's a break, you innately settle down.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes want to sit down if you're in a venue. Sometimes you look for your drink subconsciously. Well, that happened. So as I'm crescendoing, trying to get the headliner on, it's on its way up. We're killing, boom, 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 and then it goes.
Mm-hmm.
It flatlines at the top,
and
right?
You gotta figure out how
and
to
then I gotta go, okay, don't this hit make my people want it? And then I gotta try to get it back up. So what happens is the quality, all of that matters. All of it matters.
And the psychology. I have never thought about DJing in a psychological manner before.
It's a full out art.
It's like getting in here, the hearts and the to make them.
And that's and you know, Maul, that's such great information for that particular grind up. Mm-hmm. You know, for those of you who do DJ and are looking to access that job, definitely a lot to keep in mind, to take into consideration. So, I mean, you hear it from a dude that's doing it every single day in real time, whether it's sports, whether it's on the radio, which is another thing we're going to talk about.
Okay.
Because DJing on the radio is a whole different dynamic.
Totally different.
And DJing events, man. So, so definitely appreciate your advice and your experience on that last grind out. We're going to move into grind out number four.
But before we do.
Tell me what we got.
But before we do, guys, we are approaching our very, very, very last week to vote. To vote for our finalists. They are going to be announced next week, so let's roll it so we can see who they are.
Let's check it out.
For our 10K scholarship, Alex, Dedrick, Edwin, Tyler, Alexander, Nathaniel. Next graphic, please. We got Cassandra, Doyi, Josh, Nigel, Katz, and Maria. She reminds me of a West Side Story.
Now, last time we did this,
nobody got my joke?
I did. I'm sorry.
You remind me of a West Side Story.
You're welcome.
Maria. So, when we did this, you know, last week, I think Doyi was at 600 and something votes for her, her 10K scholarship that we gave away. So, we've been telling folks, like, look, get your community together, get your folks, get the folks that root you on, get them to vote for you, because this is crucial, because we're narrowing it down.
It is a $10,000 scholarship.
$10,000 scholarship in film, you know, engineering, radio, recording, and we're narrowing it down to our four. So when is that?
Midnight tonight. Midnight tonight. That is the last, that's the end of it for the voting.
So I'm going to say this personally, because I know Katz has been tuning in since show one. Katz, I'm pulling for you, bro. So look, call your sister. Tell your sister to call her homegirls. Shoot, her homegirls could be my homegirls.
Call the cousins.
We call the cousins.
Call the church. Call the soprano church. Section at church. Call everybody.
What a pressure.
Get your votes in.
To come vote get for your you
votes
right
in.
Now.
Get your votes in. And honestly, I mean, that goes for everybody that's looking to obtain this 4K scholarship, okay? So let's get these votes
10K,
in, guys.
10K.
Let's get these votes in. So
now I think we can move into grind out four.
Cool. Let's move into grind out four. I love it. Moving. Monday takeover. What
Monday,
we got?
We're taking it over. It's going like this.
Grind out four. Let's go.
Let's go. Grind out four.
Videographer needed. Brownsville, Texas. City of Brownsville needs a vibrant, energetic videographer to help film events for the city. General duties include operation of video camera, assist director with overall production, assist editors as needed. At least 6 months work experience and or technical training. General knowledge of cameras and editing software required. Now this actually is like, this is Chloe's world.
Okay.
Well.
So Chloe, I'm gonna let you chime in on the details of this grind up.
So it kind of, this is in the world of, because this is in the world of what we were talking about with the sports job, right? Mm-hmm. And the ability to take a mood, take a setting, take a whatever, and translate it through video, right? So you might have some raw footage, and it is your job to tell this story through the filter from the voice of this particular event or show or whatever. Mm-hmm. And that's basically what this job is highlighting. I think that it also speaks to what we were saying before about having a love for that thing. Because what are they asking for? Vibrant, energetic.
Energetic, yeah.
So if you're like 3 minutes from it and 30 minutes past it, this is probably not your grind job. You know what I'm saying? Because that's your main job as a videographer, is telling a story. 6 months experience, that's not a lot of time when you come down to it.
Right.
Which to me says that you have to have worked in this field as well. Have to have worked in this field already.
Right. Which is another grind up that is great for our RRFC students
100%.
Who are in film, because again, you know, that's something they're very accustomed to, which is being on a film set.
Yeah.
Kind of knowing the workflow, you know, where to be, where not to be, how to work with, you know, directors, you know, PAs and stuff. So.
And in terms of what they're asking for with those specifics, they're not asking for like a ton of know how to operate a camera. Great.
Software equipment.
Great.
Easy.
Yeah.
Great.
Simple.
Which also to me says that there is a fair amount of Hard Knocks Learning. Mm. You know what I mean? Yeah, which we'll get absolutely. Into in a second, our mm-hmm. our School of Hard Knocks at this one here. Mm-hmm. So elegantly executes. But yeah, so I think that this would be great way to get in and spread your wings and the end.
Mm. Okay.
The end.
So before we get into Grind 5, mm-hmm. I know we have something else. Or are we going directly into it?
We're gonna just say get your Q&A ready.
Oh yeah.
That's all I was gonna say.
Get your questions ready.
Get it ready.
Because we're popping when it happens. Mm-hmm. Nobody's waiting for you.
No, we want you to be ready for these questions, Mo.
Let's get it. Whatever okay? you ask.
I'm gonna come at you left
I
or
got
right.
You.
Like, you're in the hot couch.
You know, you gotta get you gotta cough up the secrets, bro.
It don't matter. Whatever you ask, okay. I'm bringing them to you. Woo! Any questions you ask as it relates to anything. Let's
okay,
go.
Okay, cool. Here we go. So fifth grind up of the day is
our last grind
in the field of sound designer, which is very fun. This is in Cambridge, MA. I'm going to say MA because MA could be
Massachusetts.
There Cambridge, we go. Yes, across the bridge.
Here we go. Top virtual instrument software company seeks experienced sound designer to revamp sound library. Oh. Work with third-party artists and producers in creating new libraries. Record and mix live instruments. Produce unique sounds that will be exclusive to sound library. Knowledge of audio software, Pro Tools, Ableton, Logic, etc., and at least 3 years experience as a professional sound designer, bachelor's degree, or equivalent required. Mm. Now, sound designing is always fun, man, because yeah. like I equate it to like the days we were sampling and building our own libraries yes. and sounds. And uh-huh. it's so important as a sound designer to actually know sonics, you know, balance, left, right, stereo, mono, mm-hmm. you know, and we come from the day of like getting a gritty sound,
yes,
right? Got the
yes.
crackle, the dirt,
yes.
the record popping.
SP-1200s.
Right. Uh-huh. So it's always fun, I think, because you kind of get to explore, you mm-hmm, know, and mm-hmm. it's kind of like to your liking or to your mm-hmm. preference of what you think a dope sound is. You know, mm-hmm. everybody has a different idea.
Well, sound designer, it's again, layperson, but you are telling that story, but through music.
Mm-hmm. Through music, through
right?
a sound.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
You know, a lot of it, too, is like, well, you know, when you're scoring a movie.
Absolutely.
There's particular certain sounds that you use for, let's say, a moment that's really
tense
or intense mm-hmm. or a moment that's very, you know, tear-jerking mm-hmm. or intimate. Mm-hmm. You know mm-hmm. what I'm saying? And mm-hmm. it's knowing those things and how to build those sounds.
Yeah.
It's very, mm-hmm. very... Not, I'm not gonna say hard, man, but it's intricate.
It's very intricate in a sense of, and this being for a virtual instrument company.
Yeah.
So they're already an instrument company, so yeah. I'm assuming they have certain instruments. This right. would be the ability to combine and make different sounds.
Right. Or
update.
Or update. Yeah. So you'd already. Be kind of be taking their existing catalog of sounds, and really bringing them up to speed or updating mm-hmm. them, and then mm-hmm. you know capturing sounds that they don't have, that, mm-hmm. that don't exist in their existing library. So,
I mean, that just sounds like so much fun.
It yes, is fun, man.
It, does.
It is fun.
Yeah. yeah, shout out to Cambridge. Everybody in that Boston, Cambridge area, go see.
Boston.
Go see it.
Go
get
see
it.
It.
Boston.
Go get it. Go get it.
So, Cloie, yeah. that is our fifth grind up of the day.
Sure is.
Now we do have an additional.
Oh
additional.
Boy, do we.
Yeah.
So five grind ups.
You
so
made me
we're
didn't
at
know this.
10 now. I think, you know, mm-hmm. I think since the last time we talked, we were at 5. We're at 10
yeah.
now, bro. So
wow.
these additional 5 you find on our website.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
We've got in film, a paid creative trainee in Culver City, California. That's also in our backyard. Another in film, freelance video editor, Santa mm-hmm. Monica. That's also here. Shout out California. Mm-hmm. In the field of radio, we have an on-air country radio personality in Milwaukee, mm-hmm. Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Also in LA, recording. We've got a soundstage manager. Mm-hmm. And in the field of culinary, we've got a cook for our country club for the PM shift. Let's be specific. So you're talking
uh-huh.
about some dinner.
Late night.
Steaks. Because uh-huh. it's in Houston, Texas.
Cue going on.
All
yes.
some Wagyu
yes.
beef and Angus and the whole Kobe, all of them.
Kobe beef.
That Kobe that beef. That uh-huh. Kobe beef. Yeah.
yeah.
So that's uh-huh. 10 jobs. The guys,
wow.
guys, we're just we're left, right, and center, just jobs.
Man, I don't know what's going on in Washington, D.C., but we got jobs here.
Oh. Mm-hmm.
We got jobs.
Huh.
Well.
All
right. Well.
So what else we got? What else we got today?
Well, before we go into anything else, we do have our School of Hard Knocks.
Mm-hmm.
And this week, we're talking about what it means to be an entrepreneur. School of Hard Knocks, for those of you that are just joining us. Also, for those of you that are just joining us, hello and welcome. Put a one in that chat box and shout out where you're from. Chat box is in your upper right. If you're on the thing, the internet thing, the internet.
On the thing.
Yeah.
Okay, mama.
Wait, specifically, we're going to flash to this clip that we do for our School of Hard Knocks, which is like real world experience, which we touched on a little bit ago. And this is about technology and how it influences the entrepreneurial mindset. So I feel like now's the time. Let's check it out, shall we?
You have to understand all the different elements or facets of what that means, right? Entrepreneurship today is like, you got to look at yourself like a walking business, because whatever it is you're doing or whatever it is your craft is, you have to understand how all the pieces work together. And part of understanding that comes with being or having the mindset of an entrepreneur. You know, it's not just talent, it's not just skill, it's knowing how to apply the other end, which maybe isn't so easy for you. You know, for me, like, making music is the easiest part. It's how do I convey that message? How do I entice business? How do I bring in those elements? And being able to understand all those facets of what entrepreneurship is extremely important, because you are the business. How well you communicate, your ability to show up on time. All those fundamentals are outside of what comes easy to you, which is the craft or if it's a skill. So being able to understand how all those things come together and play their role is a huge part of being an entrepreneur.
That is a good job. Good job. You don't suck at that.
That was good.
So before we go any further, there is a birthday in the house.
Hey.
A soothsayer once said in Julius Caesar, beware the Ides of March. I say we are reclaiming them here on Connected with the birthday of this one right here.
Pisces all day.
Pisces all day. So without any further ado, me.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to ya. Happy birthday.
Everybody can sing. It's okay. We're live.
Yeah, we're live.
The crew is looking at me like,
he's like, I'm not singing. So happy birthday.
Do I blow them out now?
Don't act like you don't know what to do with a candle on a cake.
Hey.
I just wasn't sure if you guys were finishing the song. Thank you, guys. Thank you.
Yay.
Thank you, Cloie. Thank you, Mosky. Thank you to my Connected team who always look out for me and got me a cake. Now, you know, just the kid in me says, where's the milk? But
milk? People still drink milk?
Yeah. So, you know, I don't want to be like a greedoid on camera, so I'm going to set that right there. And yes, it is my birthday month.
Yes.
Yes. And I look to see you guys on Saturday because I am having a birthday bash. Mm-hmm. So, yes, I'm saying it live.
Let's
get it. If anybody decides to cop out, we got it on tape.
I show up.
You do. So, we're going to move this birthday Monday takeover along here.
With some Q&A.
But before we go into Q&A, there's something I want to touch on really quick, which was our School of Hard Knocks video.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And I kind of want to get a little bit of your insight on this, Ma, because, you know, I think as kids, we saw a lot of great talent around us. We saw a lot of great grown-up talent around us, right? Mm-hmm. But we always wondered why they couldn't get off their mom's couch. Right? So
yes.
A lot of it, woo-hoo, you know, where you look at today where the skill set and the business mind is going, they've kind of have come together because now it's not so much about your talent, although talent is what gets you, you know,
in the door.
To the door. Yeah. But your skill set as entrepreneur or being business minded now has to come into play.
Absolutely.
And just even in your role, whether it's you DJing for the Rams, taking a meeting at KJLH before you got the gig, you know, what are some of those things that you felt instantly kicked in on the knowledge side as far as, okay, let me get my posture, let me get my mouthpiece together. How did those things eventually come together with your skill?
Well, the first of all, the understanding that you are a brand,
right?
Like, first, even, I mean, most creatives, you know, walk around, they don't shave, and they just walk around the same sweats for like 3 days, you know what I mean? Like, and you're like, no, if you realize that you are a brand, just like that Roland keyboard, or like the DJ Roland DJ 808 is a brand, like the same way that brand is ready to be shown camera ready whenever, you should be camera ready whenever and ready to be shown. The same way people discuss cars or discuss any of their products, you should discuss you as your product, you know, in the same way. Yeah. But in a way that's palatable or that's, you know, accessible to someone who's not a creative. Right. See, when we grew up around artists that were really creative but could not communicate what they were doing to the average ear. So you have this singer singing, doing all these different runs and whatnot, but it doesn't necessarily communicate or you know come across to the normal listener. They're like, mm-hmm. I don't understand. And if you're a musician, you're like, oh my God. Right, but yeah. The normal listener is like, what is that? So understanding that whatever it is your thing is, you have to be able to communicate it. So for me, when I walk into the Rams office, when I walked into the Sparks office, when I walked in to do the Kobe's last game as the Lakers, you know, with the Lakers, you know, my thing was understanding that I'm a brand. Presentation is everything. Mm-hmm. Communication, how you communicate. If I walk in saying, hey, cuz, let me get this job. If I walk in, right. All of that matters. Every mm-hmm. detail matters because there's not necessarily time for them to background check you
right.
and verify you, if you right. will. You know what I mean? So a lot of times, understanding that all of that matters as it relates to the business of you. Mm. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So with that said, if you take it like, when I walked into the Sparks office, right? Did I walk in shorts and some, you know, in a hip hop shirt and right. some Jordans?
Right.
No, like you actually have to understand each and how it relates in right. each, you know. Now, when I walk into the Rams office, I'm dressed one way. When I walked into KJLH, I'm dressed a total different way.
Right.
For that setting, the same way you would be right. walking into. So just understanding how that relates yeah. in all of it.
And that's such crucial information, man, because. Mm-hmm. You know, the key thing is for, and it, you know, it lends itself to other areas mm-hmm. of your pursuit. You mm-hmm. know, it's not just DJing. It's not just, you know, being on camera. It's not just getting the engineering gig. It's just understanding those core fundamentals
mm-hmm.
of that entrepreneurial component along with your skill or mm-hmm. your talent and mm-hmm. how they, nowadays where the world has turned, they have to coincide. They have to coexist.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. What I was going to say is any entrepreneur, any successful entrepreneur, right? If you create a business, the very first thing you do, let's say, Cloie, you decide to fry chicken or something. I don't know. If you decide to do a fruit stand, right? And it's good. Everybody loves your fruit stand. It becomes successful. Mm-hmm. You create it. All right, we're going to build and make a fruit stand place. You create this location. Any entrepreneur, the first thing they're going to tell you is get out the kitchen. The first thing they're going to tell you is train someone else mm-hmm. to do that, and you focus on the business side.
Yes.
So when we were growing up, no one told us that get off of doing those scales and go focus on the business side. Mm-hmm. Nobody told us that just like you're waking up every morning practicing crab scratching, you have to be doing the same, you know, be as intentional about the business practice. Mm-hmm. So
well put. And that is actually great for us to segue into the questions we got for you, man. So
we're
kind of high tech here, man. So we kind of get our questions in live.
Live? Okay.
Phone.
Bring it. So I'm going to stretch out.
I'm going to read. I'm going to kind of like join you on your phone for these questions.
Sure.
So let's see. What? First of all, do we have our viewers who put the one in? So we can kind of shout out where they're from.
Well, team, could we do that? Because I just got questions.
Let's hit with the questions. If that's what we got, let's roll.
So the first question is Tim from Georgia wants to know, where can I find some killer 808 samples?
Oh, Tim. Oh, maybe we should ask the producer that. Well, I can tell you there are kits. There are available kits that you can download, Tim. Many producers offer production kits. You know, for an 808 kit, you know, Little John offers kits that you can download.
And that's a great idea. Mm-hmm. I figured since we're in the house of Roland.
I mean.
Roland. Go get a Roland 808 drum machine if you really want the real essence of the 808 booms, the 808 snares, and the detuning and all that. But
that's the answer.
If you ain't from that school, I mean, I would say, you know, you can get on YouTube, Spotify. You can actually type in 808 boom and you'll be surprised what comes up. I know that's how I've been able to do it too when I'm crate digging. So various ways you can get your hands on some of that stuff and just kind of just have at it, sample away.
So now Nigel from Burbank wants to know, what were the challenging aspects of creating Happily Ever After?
So I'm assuming your success, his success story, what, that journey?
Nigel, can you give a little bit more information?
Well, I'll tell you what, let me kind of just, you know, embellish on that question. Okay. So the time you started to where you're at now, reflecting on some of those speed bumps or obstacles that you had to encounter just on that journey.
Well, first of all, the 10,000 hours, right? Becoming a master at what you do. The first thing is become a master at your craft, right? Once you master your craft, then you can take that mastery, teach it, perform it, play it, do whatever, but first become a master at your craft. Secondly, you know, for me, in that process, there were a lot of bumps and bruises, and you learn, you understand, you start to get, you know, information. You know, I have an experience where I actually left home and went to the military. You know this. You dropped me off, you know. And it was, I mean, I think it was a mistake because I feel like I lost out on 5 years of of experience in music because I went away thinking I need a job, I need insurance, I need this. Yeah, I don't want to provide for my traditional structure. I need to provide for my family. But I feel like I lost out. So when I came back, I literally had to start over.
Over time.
And what people don't understand is the game moves so fast. In DJing, you cannot take 6 months off. You are lost. You are a wiffle ball in a high wind when you get back. You know, you're lost. So you know, staying in that and doing a due season to get to Happily Ever After. And then what happens is Happily Ever After actually happens before you know it. You're like, whoa, wait a minute, that just happened. And sometimes if you're like us, you're so ambitious, you're so focused on the next step that you're like, dang, that happened, but I'm going towards, dang, that happened, but I'm, dang, I reached this financial goal, but I want this financial goal.
And it's, so, it's crazy you say that because even for me, what I found in interviews is when people point out these key things that have happened in my career, that is the true only time I actually get to reflect to where it's like, wait a minute. I because like you said, you're so focused on the next that sometimes you don't really get to take in, you know, those achievements and those accomplishments until you get, you actually sit down and it ain't about anything else other than why you're here today.
Exactly. We just did I just did Staples Center, Usher, Bryson Tiller, and I'm DJing. I leave there and everybody's like, oh my God, you just did the Staples Center. Can you believe it was 27,000 and you were killing? I'm like, yeah, but I'm on my way to go DJ this next event. My mind was already so focused on the next event with Stevie Wonder that I didn't even remember that someone else later on, it was like, wait a minute, that was a dream in itself. That was a goal accomplished in itself.
And that, and that's a great thing because I think it's so important for people to understand really what it means to be on your A game. And when you're on your A game, that's just how it goes. You know, you're able to execute in any kind of environment, don't matter the time or day. It's like this. It's second nature. And it, and to get to that point, man, it's a lot of work. Like you said, 10,000 hours
to become a master
at your craft.
Yep.
And that's the work. And it's so important for our viewers to understand that because a lot of them are just getting into their craft, getting into that roadmap, that framework of what their future is going to be.
And the mindset is different now, too, not for nothing. The immediacy of technology. Everybody wants to wake up and be a DJ. Everybody wants to wake up and think they're an actor, even. And, but, and it's not that.
But what people understand, just another, I know I'm being long-winded, but sorry. But what people got to understand is what the 10,000 hours does is it hones in your voice, right? So as a DJ, I could tell you right now, if you want to be a DJ, buy a DJ Roland DJ 808, right? And download the top 40, top 100 songs in the country and blend them together. Does that make you a DJ, really? But the thing is it doesn't give you a voice. And the reason why you'll get one of these jobs, like one of the grind ops was creating an environment, is because of your, the way you do it. If you just, you know, the 10,000 hours is what helps you helps you define your character. You know, as an actor, you don't even really know what type of actor you are. I could just play anything. Not, that's not realistic. That's
what do you do better
what
than
do
anybody?
You better, you know, for me.
And that's okay.
Yeah, and you don't understand that when you first starting. You're just, I just want to be. I made 6 beats, so I'm a producer. Okay, so what's your, you know, specificity? Where is your lane?
Right.
You don't know it until you've gone through enough time.
Yeah. And that's key. I think what we're, you know, what we're talking about is just developing a personality, something that's exclusive to you, that separates you from everybody who's doing it. Because I will say this, everybody is doing what we do.
Yes.
And the only thing that separates you is obviously your skill level, but how you do it.
Well, let me, I'm going to cut you off, but here's the thing. So if you know basketball, right, in the NBA, right, everybody on the NBA, and you get to a certain skill level, everybody jumps just as high. Everybody is just as fast. Everybody can run as long and shoot just as good, you know? So there's a thing that separates you. Like, you know, Klay Thompson and Steph Curry, they both shoot really well, but one is a point guard in addition. One is not a point guard in addition, right? But they both shoot really well. You know, what separates you from the rest is what is going to define you and make you, you
define
know,
your position.
You know, what? Mm-hmm. This is real funny. This is in the acting world of the same conversation. I am going to be starting on a film project in the next few weeks, and I didn't even audition. They just wanted to meet me.
Nice.
And it's also because of that same thing. At a certain point, everybody can act. Everybody can do what they want to do. But it's like, who are you? Because these characters, some of them will be heavily influenced. Exactly.
Yeah, yeah. You'll be able to put a little bit of you into it.
And or that gives, all or of a lot me of or you. Whatever. Mm-hmm. Exactly. But it's that same thing of like, if I'm going in there like, well, I mean, I don't know. Can you give me something to read? No. No, at this point in the game. Yeah.
What other questions do we have from Malski?
Lots. Okay. Micah from Spokane, Washington. Mm-hmm. I'm a producer. Producer, as in I make music on Ableton, Reason, etc.
Okay.
He put that in there.
Okay.
I plan on moving to LA this fall. What should I be doing now to find a job in LA?
Huh. Tuning in, applying.
Absolutely.
Number one, tuning in, applying. I would suggest, I mean, a little bit more, what should you do to find a job? You could search random job sites here outside of, you know, this connected show. If you're looking for a job in the area, in production, there are a lot of people looking for assistance. I would suggest becoming someone's assistant. You know, a paid internship or assistant are always good in the field. I mean, if you're a producer and you're Iz's assistant, it puts you in the realm, you see, you get experience, it's OJT, plus you get paid at the same time.
Right.
I would suggest that. But moving here, getting your catalog of music and sound and songs up. Not just beats, songs. Get writers to put, you know, like lyrics and create full out songs and be ready with a catalog when you get here. Mm. That's what I would say.
Well said.
Done. Mm-hmm. Okay, so then we have Zoe from Boston.
Zoe!
How long does it take to get really good at being a live DJ, like what Malski do, like
what
Malski does?
Shout out to Beantown. It takes a while. In what I do, the thing that separates me, and I could give you that, is that I grew up as an MC. I was an MC first who just knew music. I mean, me and Izzy would, you know, as children would ride around in the car and freestyle and rap. We were both MCs first. So in a sense of DJing, I have this combination of both that a lot of people can't do. There are a lot of great DJs with great fingers and great hands and great touch and even great sensitivity to crowd, but they can't MC as well. So for me, that was what set me apart, and that was how I got to the place where I am, because I could offer two in one. Right. So when I walk to the, when I go to the Sparks, I could be your on game, your in game host that does the competitions, interviews Magic Johnson sitting courtside, interviews Floyd Mayweather sitting courtside, gets back in the DJ booth and plays all the music. That's what, how I got to where I am. So I would suggest figuring out your lane, conquering your lane, and going to where your lane is most beneficial.
Mm-hmm. Mm. I love it.
Great stuff.
Bam. Clark from Athens, Georgia.
Clark
Georgia,
Kent.
Right? From Malski. Mm-hmm. Hey, man. Was looking you up. Says you did music for some films and TV.
I did.
Mm-hmm. How'd you get in there and do that?
Well, as Iz said earlier, I produce as well. A good friend of mine, director Sheldon Candace, he was working on an independent film initially. And he came over to the studio, listened to some music, and he was like, man, you know what? I think I could use some of that music in my film coming up. I said, you know what? I'm actually interested in learning, you know, some of the, mm-hmm. you know, some of that technique. So here, I'm gonna bring you a bunch of tracks, teach me the process. Mm-hmm. I got to sit with him, see the process, and from that, another three independent films, two theatrical productions came from that, just from learning. So sitting, watching, being a sponge, mm-hmm. understanding that game. I didn't just jump in it. Like, I didn't work with one film and go, hey guys, I film score now. Right. It was like, no, I learned, tried to get another independent, tried to build, tried to, you know, and just understand as much as possible in that area.
Work.
Yeah.
All right, so we got Diz from Compton.
Compton.
He says, got a couple guys I rap with. They come over and we lay stuff out, but looks like it always ends up getting competitive instead of collaborative. Has this ever happened to you? What can I do to keep the peace? It got pretty heated for a minute last week. Thought it might come to blows, all that. Whoa. Ooh.
So I would say, you know, the thing when it comes to that type of thing with MCing, I mean, it's always great to be competitive because hearing somebody yes. that possibly sounds better than right. you only makes you better. Right. However, when you're in a crew, it should never, ever come to that.
Ever.
You know, and that's for me, like, even in our days and when we had our crews, and you can definitely, you know, account mm-hmm. to this, Malski, is that we were always competitive. We were always, you know, fearful of who was going to be better, but it never came to that. And yes. that, you define your crew or your brotherhood by, you know, family, the principles of what that means
yes.
is having each other's back and never hating on anybody, wanting to see each other grow
right.
and become successful. You know, that would only cause me to really, like, double look or double back on the crew I'm in, mm-hmm. you know, when it comes
absolutely.
To
mm-hmm.
That's mm-hmm. not good for anybody. Mm-hmm. And, you know, it's one thing to get in there and be competitive and create a really incredible song. Everybody's verse is right and dope. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. But it's another thing to, like, not get anywhere at the end of the day and wasted time. That, mm-hmm. to me, sounds like wasted time.
Mm-hmm,
so it's
mm-hmm.
the difference between competition and inspiration is what I hear you saying.
Yeah. I mean, coming to blows, I mean, come on. Who's yeah. got time for that these days?
Yeah, yeah. I would even just chime in, like, Motown, you know, with Berry Gordy was very competitive. Berry Gordy would literally take the same song to four different producers in the same house. In the same house,
yep.
they would all compete for the same. So it was competitive, but the best man got the job. But it mm-hmm. was never an issue of, you know, debating because he understood art is how you paint it.
Right,
mm-hmm. it's how you absolutely. Paint it. So there's really no competition because
right.
it's how you paint it is how you paint it. How I paint it is how I paint it.
And it's the difference between the story that they want to tell.
Yeah, but that's what would make your crew so much better is understanding that
right.
how each of you paint it. Is how you paint it.
Right.
And that's what will make you collectively dope, you yeah. know? Wu-Tang style, but the West Coast style.
So we got a question. So Nigel, also from Burbank, wants to know, where do you typically find new artists and music to DJ?
I have a connection now. Initially, I would go out. Initially, first of all, if you're a DJ and you're not out 5 days a week, you're not doing your job. Not just when you're DJing. You should be out every night, right? So initially, I would be out and I would see these artists. People would come up. You know, other people would perform. And then what started happening is relationship with labels. And labels are like, we're looking at this artist, we're looking at this artist. And then it became going to different studios because a lot of artists, because I do radio, want to, you know, I'll come and pick singles for different artists.
Mm-hmm.
So I'll be in a studio and listening to the whole album and they'll say, pick a single, and I'll pick the single, and they'll go, by the way, we have this new artist we're working mm-hmm. with. Why don't you listen and tell me what you think? So a combination of all of that is how now I get new music. Labels will send it. Spotify, I was on Spotify mm-hmm. today mm-hmm. listening to a new record, Ill Camille. Man, shout out to Ill Camille. Whew. But yeah, like always, really.
Yeah.
And always looking out for the next thing. If you're a real DJ, like, not an old dude out here. If you're a real DJ, you're looking for the next thing.
Right.
Because you want to be the one who breaks
right.
it.
Yeah.
You know, so.
Right.
Dope.
So then we got also Tim from Atlanta. Shout out to Nigel and Tim blowing up the chat today. Mm-hmm. What does side chaining do? Bless you.
Side chaining.
Cricket!
I don't know, chainsaw? I mean, I put the chain on? I'm not sure. Let's move to the next question.
Love it. Okay. All right, so this is various parts. So Enzi from Detroit, Michigan, wants to know several things, but wants to know who the most famous person you've met is, who is the nicest, doesn't really want to ask, but kind of wants to know who is the worst, right? And then also wants to know, in terms of urban, are there any challenges that you have met, or any adversity in the war, in the very, very hot button world of race?
Okay, let's see, most famous person. I work with the greatest songwriter of all time, Stevie Wonder.
Well,
so,
isn't he lovely?
He is, isn't he lovely? Nice.
You see what I did
there? Do I do? You know what I'm talking about?
He's the master, for real.
He is the master. So, Master Blaster. He is the greatest songwriter of all times, in my opinion. You know, I have the privilege of working with him as his DJ, at his station, as, you know, his connection to a lot of what's going on now in today's world of music. And so that would be that, as far as the most famous, most notable to me. And I consider him a friend, you know, a mentor and a friend. As far as someone who has the biggest attitude, I don't really want to put anybody on blast.
Oh, man, we hold no punches here, bro.
Oh, we hold no punches?
We hold no punches. It's connected.
Well, I'm going to tell you right
Throw
now.
Throw it out there. Give it to me.
Listen, listen. Don't go at me, but
don't
Nicki
say
Minaj.
Nicki Minaj. Oh no!
Don't go at me. Now, mind you, let me give credit where credit's due.
She's gonna come hard.
Listen, listen. Let me give All credit right. where credit's due.
All right.
Her new records, No Fraud. Ooh! And like the new records that she just put out are crazy. But when we the three times that we've been around each other, it has been drama. It just has been issues, and I've done nothing but try to help the shows that she's been on, you know, yada yada, but it's just been, you know, somebody will be, I'll be standing there and somebody will just have a camera and she'll just be like, what are you doing? And or just randomly, and I'll be like, oh, okay, all right, cool, no problem, no issue.
Right.
I don't have no issue, I'm neutral. I'm trying to make it better for you, so I don't have no problems, but that's the only real, like, weirdness I've had. And I don't know, you know, I'm sure as beautiful as she is, I'm sure guys are trying to get at her all the time. I don't know if she thought maybe I was one, but you know, I got
titanium.
I got the one. How you know what I'm talking about?
Yeah, so, But anyway, before we go any further, how are we looking on time? Are we good?
We should. We got a couple more questions and we'll wrap it up.
Okay.
So then.
I've been long winded.
No, no,
no. You're good,
this
man.
Is
okay.
perfect.
That's okay.
This
That's
is perfect. Bro. So the follow up to the last part of Enzi's question was about race, and how do you encounter any adversity from either side in like urban and all?
Well, it's interesting because the some of the venues that I play at, right, are the most diverse you can be at. I mean, an LA Rams game, 92,000 people, right? There's every race. Pretty much every age. I don't think there's any like newborns, but pretty much every age, every race. And so I've had a couple of times where I'll be either at Coliseum for a Rams game or a Sparks game or a Lakers event or something like that where, you know, a guy would just say, can you not play all that rap? You know, like a random guy would typecast me, if you will. And are you just gonna play all of your music? Like, what's all my music?
Right.
What is that? You didn't even know I was about to play Led Zeppelin, but now I'm about to play 50 Cent. You know what I mean? But not sometimes that's happened. And if you understand that you're a brand and you're a business, you know how to handle it. You handle it with grace, with humility, and you handle it in a way that says, hey man, you know, whatever you'd like to hear, I'd love to play it. Whatever you'd like to hear,
scholar.
Do you have any requests? All right, so last question. We have Belle from Chicago.
Chi-Town.
Do female DJs have to do something different to get noticed in radio? I notice they either have boring radio jobs like announcing stuff, or they're the co-host who is supposed to chime in every now and again. Okay. Mm. And she wants to be a shock jock.
Okay. So now, there is a difference between a DJ and a personality, okay, in radio. It's different. The DJ is the one controlling the music, playing the music, right? Mm-hmm. The jock or the personality. Now, sometimes they're one and the same.
Like you.
Like myself. Mm-hmm. Now, sometimes they are one and the same. But there are many cases where they are not one and the same, i.e., the biggest show on the West Coast, the Big Boy in the Morning Show. Mm-hmm. Big Boy is the jock. DJ Vic One is the DJ, mm-hmm. right? So Big Boy, while he's handling the personality-driven things and running the show, Vic One is DJing and running the music, right? So for her, she's saying mostly DJs, women, female DJs are either in a boring or only can chime in at certain times. Well, one of the biggest female DJs in the world is here in LA, DJ Charisma. Hmm. And she got it popping. There's no boring in DJ Charisma. She's popping. She's dope at it, right? But she's the DJ, not the jock. Mm-hmm. The personalities that she work with, it depends on whoever, you know, it is at the time. So understanding that first. If you want to be a shock jock, work on your personality, your tonation or your voice, mm-hmm. and things that create a theater in the mind. If you want to be a DJ, work on your ability and right. skills. Not to be both, it's very rare, but you can do it. Big right. Tig is one of them.
Yeah, mm-hmm. absolutely.
You know, Big Tig, DJ Envy is one of them. Shout to Envy, you know. And it's a lot of guys that are like that can do both. Right. So Felly Fell is one of them that can do both, you know. So there you okay. have it.
Well, yeah. I do have a question from a man.
Uh-oh. You said anything.
Because a DJ's got to ask a fellow DJ this question.
Uh-huh.
One of the most favorite records you love to play when you're doing the set?
Oh man, that's the hardest.
What is that one record that gives you a good feeling as a DJ, like your go-to joint?
Well, it's got to be two. It's got to be
two. I'll give
it
you two.
One. Right, two and me. Here's the reason, because there are two different. So people don't understand. There's two different types of DJs, right? There's the artist DJ, and there's the service DJ mm-hmm. right? The artist DJ is the DJ you go to hear what they are going to play, mm-hmm. regardless who's there, right? So they're coming in with a preconceived set, not dissing anyone, right. but they're coming in saying, you're coming in here what I'm gonna play,
right?
The service DJ is the DJ that says, I'm gonna play with everybody, whatever's here.
Right.
So I'm gonna look at the 80% of the crowd and I'm gonna play that.
Right.
That's what I do, I'm okay. a service DJ. Now, so a lot of that depends on the crowd. You get what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
Now, if I were an artist DJ, my go-to would be a Stevie Wonder song. Mm-hmm. It would be Do I Do.
Mm-hmm.
It doesn't matter what happens when that song comes on, it makes me feel good.
Right.
Stevie Do I Do.
Right,
it,
okay.
If as an artist. Now, as a service DJ, it would depend on the crowd. If it's a hood crowd, it'd be one song. If it's a hills crowd, it'd be another song. You know, so it would all depend. You know, all depend on that.
But I have one record that I just love.
What?
Me, Myself, and I.
Oh, De La Soul? Yeah. That's the one? It's like, I gotta play that?
Yeah. Man. It's just my, no matter where I'm at.
You will find
if
what?
If I find the right moment, mm-hmm. and I throw, that is just.
I think Usher's You Don't Have to Call mm-hmm. would be mine.
Okay.
Because it was at a time where I related to the record perfectly.
Right.
So it was like, and the core progression,
right.
and the energy, and yeah. I think Usher's You Don't
story.
Have to Call
would
be that okay. record for me. So.
Well, man, you all have heard it from, you know, none other than like I said, the most busiest DJ in LA we got right now. My man is
Thank
doing
you.
It with USC, the Rams,
Sparks,
KJLH. I mean, Thank that's you. What you call a true craftsman. Mm-hmm. of his work, and that's DJ Malski, man. So happy to have you here with us today at Roland, man. And we're going to let you close out the set, man.
Yes.
You know, we got to let you get back on the DJ.
I had a question. Somebody sent me a text. How many events I did last year?
187. Wow.
Yeah, so.
And he's a family man.
Yeah.
Well, there's that, too.
There's that,
I'll
too,
be first.
Yeah,
I'll be.
So. Definitely, man. Thank you for coming to hang with us today, man. Is there any place we can tell our viewers where they can find you?
DJMalski.com or any of the social medias at DJMalski.
Love it.
There you
pronounce
have it.
Malski.
And shout out to our connected team who are here in this building making it happen. Making sure the audio, the visuals on point. Shout out to my man Mark and Igor over at Roland. Mm-hmm. Go ahead.
Yeah. Oh, it's so sweet. So sweet. That's my other voice. Where can we find you?
You can find me wherever I go.
Hey.
You can find me at Twitter @_Avila. Also, too, my Instagram is Avila.
Mm-hmm. I love that. I'm @AlwaysChloe. I feel like you all should know where to find us.
Yes.
Because we are connected.
There's a lot to follow. I'm going to let the graphics go ahead. Go ahead, Chloe.
Done. So, on social media, you can find us everywhere @IsConnected. On email, that's where you want to send your demos, your links, your resumes, all that good stuff. Connected@rrfedu.com. To sign up for Connected, find us at rrfedu.com/connected. And of course, our Facebook Messenger app, which is rrfedu.com/connected/app. Second slide, please. Brrrum. To apply for our jobs, check out rrfedu.com/connected/latest. That's going to have the latest and the greatest, including the 6 grind ops that we have only on our website. For resources for resumes, be sure to check out our vault, rrfedu.com/connected/vault. And check out our weekly newsletter, which is coming out a little bit later today. And it's going to be rrfedu.com/weekly-report. Bring us on in, boys.
Mirror, mirror on the wall, tell me, mirror, what is wrong? Can it be my daylight clothes, or is it just my daylight song?